Yeah, Amy Pickering supposedly sent a lot of letters round. Is that right?
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Did they actually? Did they? Were they important?
She was working for. She worked for Discord. See, and yeah. So that was sort of the. As I'm saying, she was a mail order person at Discord.
She worked for NPC as well.
She held those things out to everybody, and I have a couple of them. Yeah.
Oh, do you?
Sure.
Are they quite lengthy or are they short?
Oh, no, they're just one page, and it just says. Usually it would just be something cryptic, like, get ready, it's Revolution Summer.
Yeah.
That's all it would say.
Do you think they had an impact?
Yes. I mean, I know, I mean, I can say the fact that you're asking me about it would say, actually, absolutely. I mean, 25 years later and you're asking me about it, so it must have had some impact.
Yeah, it must have.
In terms of the actual, at the time, I think it was just, it was an ingredient that really helped everybody move along, sure. I mean, Amy was very, very much a proponent. I mean, she was in the band Fire Party, which I think came directly out of Revolution Summer, although a little bit later. But they were, you know, the people involved with the band Fire Party were really hugely involved with Revolution Summer. And Amy, I think, was very much interested in the idea of kickstarting something.
Okay.
And I think that by doing that, that was just, I mean, I think it was an impulse on her part, but I think it was inspiring because it gave everybody, like, yeah, you know, let's fucking do this.
Do you think Revolution Summer transformed the music of DC Punk and the values and ethics of DC Punk?
I think the bands and the people associated with that era changed the music and the politics. But when you say Revolution Summer, this is where it gets a little tricky.
Yeah.
Like, we saw Revolution Summer, it was not an entity unto itself. It was just a call to arms.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying? So, yes, I would say in 1985, there was a decisive shift in the history of the DC punk underground scene.
Yeah.
No doubt. You can't deny it. But I don't want to say Revolution Summer did it because that... Because you get into the specifics of how you would define Revolution Summer. So it wasn't, it wasn't a government decree. It wasn't a decree. It was rather just people trying to get busy and then setting a date and giving it a name. Mm. And it didn't all happen, you know, that summer. I mean, Revolution Summer, the spirit of Revolution Summer, it actually started a year before and lasted for, you know, 4 years after or something.
Yeah.
There were still people energized by that. It was just an idea. The idea was really that this group of people, again, wanted to recommit themselves to sort of the idea of punk as a creative, constructive community as opposed to a destructive one or nihilistic one.